stressful and dangerous time for a little boy.
Thank you.
It was a time of fun, fear, laughter, and adventure. Children could run and play as they pleased with reckless abandon. They could climb trees, play in the sand, and do what they wanted. The place and time is Gary, Indiana, in a little neighborhood called Sunrise. The years in question are 1965 to 1972. Let me show you. The neighborhood, consisting of only three streets, and most of the homes are only little ranch-style homes built on slabs of concrete through the GI Bill. And this little three-street neighborhood is less than a mile from Lake Michigan and Wall Street Beach. Again, a place where friends could have fun and play with reckless abandon. The parents would always count on the other parents looking out for the children, although I never really noticed them around. If we were playing in this neighborhood was surrounded by dunes and oak trees. If we were playing in the sand, this was a really good place. It's all sand right here and trees. And if we played in the sand and we dug down less than a foot, we could reach water. And that's how high the water table was there. And again, we climbed trees as much as we wanted. My friends and I would take butcher knives from our houses, and we would go out into the woods and take large sticks and carve them into spears. I caught mine in the sand once and couldn't find it. My mom never asked me about it, but then again, I don't think she ever knew I took it. I was the youngest of three. My sister Tammy was in the middle, and my brother Bill Jr. was the oldest. My father, Bill Sr., worked in Hammond, Indiana for Lever Brothers. He worked 80 hours a week on the hard soap lines. I always remember the smell of soap on him when he came home from work. And I always remember the way he used to tickle me on my neck with his whiskers when he tucked me into bed at night. My mother worked in a grocery store chain. She worked the front office. And I remember those few times I walked to that store with my brother or sister. It was quite a distance for us. And I'd walk into the front and I'd ask to speak to my mom. And a lady would get on the intercom and say, "Renee Gibbs, please come to the front. We have a visitor. Renee Gibbs, please come to the front." And I would stand there just with such pride having heard my mom's name called over the intercom. And then she would come up to the front and see me. And I was about this tall, and she gave me a pat on the head or something. I thought I was seeing a movie star. And she still laughs today about that, about how much pride I had of seeing her. And although this was a wonderful backdrop to grow up as a little boy, it was also a very blue-collar community. And I always knew there was people I didn't like, people I liked, and people that I feared. The same people were a family down the street called the Benders. They were still family friends today. They had a daughter just 2 months younger than me, and we had been friends since infancy. But as we grew a little older, I started playing with boys, and she started playing with girls, and that was over. Then I also had my friends Troy, Carl David, and Frankie and David Van Dyke. I ended up having a rock fight with Frankie and David. They were down the street, and I was a little farther. We were winging rocks at each other. I hit Frankie right in the head, and I always remember going around in circles. His mother eventually came down and told my mom in her ear that I cussed at her. Well, she lied, but she wanted me to get punished, even though we were throwing rocks at each other. So she had a great satisfaction watching my mother slap me in the behind with a metal spatula all the way up to the front door. And the other real cast of characters in this neighborhood were the people I was afraid of. They were the Perry sisters across the street. Whenever I tried to shoot baskets with them, they would like take my basketball and wing it down the end of the street. They were just mean all around. Then there were the Hack Boys, Gary and Alan. Gary was always spitting and swearing. And Alan, he was always mean to me. I remember riding my bike by him saying, "Ah, you can't catch me." Well, I eventually stopped just to say hi or something to him. A few seconds later, he came up and punched me in the face about 12 times. Well, it really hurt. And then I ran up to his mother and I said, "Alan, beat me up." And she said with her cat glasses, "Well, were you picking that high, Alan?" Needless to say, those boys still aren't doing very well in life. Then there was a Smith boys down the street. Dino got in a fight with my sister once, and my sister took him by the hair and ripped a big lot of hair right out of his head and left a bald spot about this big. Well, the family wasn't very happy with our family, so one of the bigger brothers decided to push my sister out for a fight. Well, my dad goes up to the house, and he wants to settle things with the father, but the father wouldn't come out. I guess he was brave enough to beat up his wife, but he wasn't brave enough to square things up with my dad. Then, down the street, there was the hillbillies. We just called them hillbillies. I never knew their name, but they never wore any shoes. We would play out in the forest, and they'd come out there sometimes, and I was always afraid of them, that they were going to, they harass us and threaten to beat us up. They were not fun to be around. But then, after a while, we always thought to look out for them, and we'd see them coming towards us. The hillbillies are coming! The hillbillies are coming! And then we'd run away, so the hillbillies couldn't get us. And then the spread. They would always be stealing things from us in the neighborhood. My dad went to their house, too, and asked the mom if they had our bike, and she said no. But then their little boy came up behind her and said, yes, mom, the bike was in the backyard. So my dad went to the backyard and found the bike stuck down in the frame. Well, we moved out of that neighborhood in 1972, and as you can see, I have a lot of great memories of the neighborhood, both good and bad. But I did learn quite a bit. I learned there are people you can trust, and people that you can't trust. And I guess I'll just call that street smarts. Thank you very much.